Hi, hello, and welcome to another session on electromagnetic field theory and waves. In today's session, we'll see how to pass this subject in the first attempt and also score very good marks. So let's get started. So if you see, this is the prescribed syllabus for electromagnetic field theory and waves according to JNTU. So most of the students feel that this is the toughest subject, as they might have heard from their seniors. But no, this is not the tough subject. We have a bit of derivations and equations in this subject, but it is not at all a tough subject. It is only related to simple mathematics. We have simple derivations and simple integrations. So if you are really good at maths, this is the easiest subject. Even though you are not good at maths, you can just practice and get very good marks in this subject. So if you see in the first unit, this is all about electrostatics. Second unit is about the magnetostatics. The third unit, you can see the Maxwell's equations. The fourth unit is about the electromagnetic wave characteristics. And the fifth unit is about the waveguides. So from the first unit, the most frequently asked questions are about the Coulomb's law. We need to derive the expression for the Coulomb's law, and you may also get a problem based on this Coulomb's law. Then another important question is the derivation of this electric field intensity. Many times the electric field intensity derivation is asked about the infinite line charge, or due to infinite sheet of charge, or due to circular ring. Then another important question is about the applications of Gauss law and the relationship between electric potential and the electric field intensity. This is also an important topic. Then we have the Maxwell's equations for electrostatic fields. One more important derivation is the expression for energy density. How to derive the expression for energy density. So till here, this is the first part of this unit. And if you see from here, these are almost all small derivations. So out of these topics, this equation, continuity equation, this is an important topic. Then we have the relaxation time. This is also a small derivation. It is also important. Poisson's and Laplace equations. This is also an important topic. So out of this capacitance, we need to derive the expressions for the parallel plate capacitor, coaxial and spherical capacitors. Then in the second unit, this is another important topic, that is the Biot-Savart law. This is similar to the Coulomb's law in electrostatics. Then we have the Ampere's circuital law and applications. This is similar to the Gauss law in electrostatics. Then we have another derivation here for the magnetic scalar and vector potentials, and the Ampere's force law. So these are the important topics which are most frequently repeated in the previous papers. And if you see the third unit, this is the smallest of all these five units. We have a small derivation about the Faraday's law transformer EMF. Another derivation is about this inconsistency of Ampere's law. Then we have the Maxwell's equations. This topic is most frequently asked. It is the conditions at a boundary surface. You may need to solve the conditions at a boundary surface for dielectric-dielectric and a dielectric-conductor interface. So you can finish off this third unit almost in 1 hour. Then if you see the fourth unit, we have the electromagnetic wave characteristics. So here one of the most important derivation is to derive the expression for the wave equations. First, in general, we need to solve the expression for the wave equation. after that we have the derivations for wave equation in conducting and perfect dielectric media. Another important topic is the relationship between E and H. Then we have the wave propagation in lossless and conducting media. And wave propagation in good conductors and good dielectrics. So these are all very easy derivations, simple derivations only. Then in the second half of this fourth unit, we have the most important topics, that is the normal incidence and oblique incidences. So here you need to solve for normal incidence and oblique incidence for both perfect conductor and perfect dielectrics. Then these are the other small topics like Brewster angle, critical angle and total internal reflection, surface impedance, pointing vector and pointing theorem. So all of till in this unit, all are these two are the long answers, that is the normal and oblique incidences. The rest of the topics from here, the Brewster angle, the critical angle, total internal reflection, from here all of these are very small topics. So you may expect at least two or three in one question. Then in the fifth unit you have this waveguides. So this unit, earlier it was in the microwave engineering subject, but now it is included in this electromagnetic field theory and waves. So here you have all lengthy derivations. The first one is the solution of wave equation in rectangular coordinates. Then you have the transverse electric and transverse magnetic mode equations. Then these are all small derivations like characteristic equation and cutoff frequencies, dominant and degenerate modes. So from here these are all short answers: characteristic equation, cutoff frequencies, dominant and degenerate modes, TE and TM modes, phase and group velocities, wavelengths and impedance relations. Another important topic in this unit is impossibility of transverse electromagnetic mode. So these are the some of the important topics in this subject. So in the coming videos we'll see how to solve these derivations along with some numericals also. Thank you for watching. Please share, like and subscribe.